I have with me Patrisse Marie Cullors. She is an artist, organizer, and freedom fighter on the Black Lives Matter team, a call to action in response to the way their lives are being devalued. Patrisse, welcome to the show, and Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Merry Christmas to you.
All right. How did you get involved with Black Lives Matter?
Actually, myself, Alicia Garza, and Opal Tameti, after the George Zimmerman acquittal last year, we created the hashtag Black Lives Matter.
Uh-huh.
And we created that hashtag from a place of grief, but also from a place of wanting to declare that Black lives matter, and that is important that we, as a nation, really look at the problems of race in this country. And then, obviously, this year the hashtag has just taken on a life of its own. Myself and Darnell Moore, we co-organized a Black Lives Matter ride to St. Louis, Ferguson.
Mm-hmm.
The third week after the uprisings there. And so we organized over 600 people, Black people, to drive into St. Louis and Ferguson. We stayed there for 2 days. And I think at that point, the hashtag was brought back to over 20-plus cities.
That's amazing. And you're located here in L.A., right?
Yep, Los Angeles, California.
Explain to us some of the demands of Black Lives Matter.
One of our biggest demands that we're going to be really working on for this upcoming year is calling on local city councils and county governments to look at how they're allocating funding specifically towards law enforcement and not into alternatives in our communities like jobs, housing, access to healthy food. And so we're going to be really trying to pass resolutions at city councils and county governments as well as in Congress to push forward a model that would really look at how we can figure out how our communities can be resourced that's not just about resourcing law enforcement.
So you're using this occasion to get more government finance or programs into the Black community?
Exactly.
But isn't that one of the primary reason that Black people are, not all but most, are so morally bankrupt is because government has been taking care of them for the last 50 or 60 years or so? Government is hurting them rather than helping them. Why do you want more government programs in the Black community?
I think that I don't know if it's government that's been morally bankrupt.
No, well, it's the government
that
has helped. Right.
Bankrupt by the lack of government services.
No, not the lack of. Too much government support has devalued Black Americans.
I don't know if I agree with that. I think there hasn't been enough support. I think especially for me, growing up in Los Angeles, I grew up in poverty and I watched my mother work 3-plus jobs, barely was able to see her. And as I went to school, I witnessed how mostly communities of color, Black communities, were segregated even in our own schools, tracked into sort of lower education. And I think that the government hasn't actually done enough for Black people.
Amazing. Were you born out of wedlock?
No, I was not.
So your father was in the home?
Yes.
And yet the two of them could not raise a family?
I don't understand your question. Raise a family.
Did your father work?
Yes, he did. Yeah, he worked for GM Van Nuys.
And your mother worked as well?
She sure did.
Well, why were you poor?
I have no idea. I think because we live in a capitalist system that some people have a lot of wealth and some people don't.
You don't support capitalism?
I think what I support is families being able to feed their children regularly. And I think the current system that we live under doesn't allow for all families to live a life of dignity.
Do you support capitalism?
I support systems that support communities. And in this current government, it's not about capitalism or not. I think it's more about who's taken care of and who's not taken care of.
Do you support capitalism?
I'm not understanding your question.
Do you support capitalism or not? She hung up. She hung up. James, get her back. See if she'll come back. Call her again. My question was quite simple. Do you support capitalism or not? And the answer is no, I believe, but she wouldn't say it. She support more government. See, folks, this is what's going on in America. They want more government. James is feeling sorry for her. She thought you got smart. James so weak. I feel your pain. James, my producer, is trying to get this woman back. She hung up on me. You can tell when they don't want to tell the truth about the question. I don't understand what you're saying. I'm not sure what you're asking me. She blamed capitalism for the problem. That's why her parents could not afford to call to her to take care of her. And so I asked, do you support capitalism? And she went all around the question, would not answer the question, and then she hung up. Isn't that something? I'm waiting to see. Oh, James said that she did not pick up. We know what that means. When we come back, she's going to get the chicken song. James, call her back and let her know that if she doesn't pick up, she's going to get the chicken song. Then she put her tail between her legs and ran. She doesn't want that in L.A. I have with me Patrisse Marie Cullors, and she is one of the founders of Black Lives Matter. She hung up on me. She ran. She put a tail between her legs and ran. She is out of L.A., so she can't be running. Let me look over at South Central Way and see if I see that woman. Oh, let me check. Going down Crenshaw, all the way down to Hoover, Vermont. Here is the chicken song from Patrisse Marie Cullors. Black Lives Matter, one of the founders. This is for you, Patrisse Marie Cullors.
Answer me.
She is gone. Ain't no use in praying for her anymore. She's gone. Let's go to Baba Go To God of Los Angeles. Baba Go To God, welcome to the show, sir.
That was epic. I mean, not just the chicken song, but the fact that she cut. I think she may have the record for the quickest cut. The quickest cut and run on your show. I don't know, Andre, I don't want to stress your staff for research like that, but I'm sure she's one of the quick ones.
I'm telling you. And she is part of Black Lives Matter, but no courage.
And the deal is, most of the people who run, since I've been listening to the show, they get upset, they threaten to leave, you know, there's a little drama, there's a little, you know, you start to back down a little bit and say, oh, no, don't run, no. And then, you know, they go. But this one just, like, disappeared like she was some Sabrina the Witch or something.
I'm telling you.
And
all I was asking if she support Does she believe in capitalism? She was on a landline, so no problem with the phones or anything. That woman ran. She was on a cell phone, James is saying, telling me. She put a tail between her legs because she was trying to get all around answering that question about capitalism. And
yeah.
This is why I tell the folks who are on the side of good, of the truth, do not be afraid of these people. They don't have courage. They only have courage if you act intimidated.
You know, I think what started it, though, if you want to get the specifics of this call, is that when you started to question, well, wait a minute, you weren't poor. Both your parents worked. He worked at GM. I'm telling you, he's not poor.
Right.
He worked at GM. They get benefits like crazy.
And she said mama was working so much that she didn't see much of her, so they had some buku money coming in.
Oh, they did. But, you know, they like to pretend, you know, that they're down with the cause. And to be down with the cause, like the Obamas, you have to fake like you had or like Hillary Clinton did, you have to fake like you had a real tough upbringing.
Yeah. Kristen out of Michigan, welcome to the show, sir.
Hey, good morning. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas to you, buddy.
Hey, I thought we'd get a little tap dancing scene, but that last guest was a full-on magician. She did the vanishing act.
I'm telling you.
Goodness gracious.
Oh, man.
It's funny, man.
James, my producer, was afraid of her when he was talking to her on the phone because she was black and she sounded so tough, and he was shaking in his boots.
Oh, no, she pulled a David Copperfield, man. She was gone. Oh, man. But, yeah, it kind of sounded shady when you were questioning her because she only mentioned her mother working three jobs. She never mentioned her father until you asked about it.
Yes.
She said he worked at GM, and I'm like, okay, there's no way she was poor. Father working at GM, mother having three jobs, just no way. She's probably making a lot of that stuff up.
Uh-huh. All lies.
But, yeah, I wanted to ask her, you know, why is it all of a sudden Black Lives Matter? All these gang members and thugs in the neighborhood killing black, innocent black folks left and right. Why didn't it matter before? You know, why is it all of a sudden when there's white cops to go after, you want to hashtag this and hashtag that? You're not hashtagging out here in the hood. I don't see you out here protesting in the hood with all these gang members and drug dealers.
That's right. She didn't have to go to Ferguson. She could have just gone right on over to South Central.
Exactly. Yeah, and that's the thing. She's in L.A., one of the top murder capitals of black people, you know, black-on-black crime. But you know what they say about these liberals? I got a quick joke for you. What do you call a bunch of liberals in the basement?
I don't know.
A wine cellar.
That's a good one.
All right. Well, Merry Christmas to everybody at Bond. And
thank you, my friend, and same back to you. I appreciate you. Greg, Wilmington, Delaware.
Hey, Jesse, you really plucked that chicken quickly.
Man, she was, at the blinking of an eye, she was gone.
You know, as soon as she came on, one of the clues was, she thought because they came up with some hashtag name that they had really done something.
I know.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I could just feel by the way she was saying it. And then as soon as you got to any kind of truth whatsoever, it was just like gone. You know, it is funny that the thing that, I don't know why, but this popped into my head during the start of your interview. We need to bring back, maybe you could channel him, we need to bring back Booker T. Washington. Because he's, you know, Booker T,
you read
his book, right?
Yeah, I love it. That's one of my heroes.
Yeah, and one thing he stressed is, like, do the basics. Like, even people in his college, like, this is how we clean, this is how we take care of ourselves. And these people, they do not understand the basics of life. I really do not think they do.